This building is dedicated to clinical research. It hosts a number of functions. One of them is a health technology accelerator. Other functions are a clinical research facility, a Surrey Sleep Research Centre, and importantly, the UK DRI Living Lab facility. We are trying to improve sleep and circadian rhythm disturbances in people living with dementia. To do so, we first need to be able to monitor sleep and circadian rhythms in great detail. Now, traditionally, recording of sleep required quite a few sensors. You can easily see that, you know, this is a lot of equipment, and it's not easy to use this equipment for longitudinal, unobtrusive recordings at home and at scale. And that's really what we would like to do. So what we are doing is using our gold standard methodology and then use new technology to see how that new technology can record sleep. For example, here we have an in-ear EEG sensor which can record signals which are brain waves. This sensor has been developed by our colleagues at Imperial College London. Here we have a radar system which also has been developed by our colleagues at Imperial College London. But there are other sensors as well. For example, if we look here, we have a simple under the mattress sensor. By putting this sensor, indeed, as the name implies, under the mattress, we can record signals such as breathing and heart rate. And by analyzing these signals, we can also determine whether the person is in bed, out of bed, and whether sleep is very much disrupted. In fact, this particular device is already implemented in the Minder trial run by our colleagues at Imperial College London and Surrey and Borders partnership. We are also interested in biomarkers for cognitive decline, biomarkers for sleep and circadian disturbances. And for this, we would like to be able to collect blood samples. And in particular, we would like to collect blood samples while the participants are asleep. And we can do this by inserting a cannula in a forearm vein. And this line then goes through this porthole to the other side of the wall where a nurse can draw the blood samples.
So within this room, we are able to monitor our participants. So we have cameras, which we are able to use during the day and the night. And we are also very interested in the light environment that people are living in. And so we now have our dynamic lighting system where we are able to change the intensity and the color of light.
The next thing I will do is show you some of the signals that we record in this polysomnography recording.
We see an EEG, an EOG, which measures eye movement, some mental EMGs and ECGs.
So you've seen the labs and the equipment that we have there. These feed through to our systems and to our visual displays so that we can see the participants' motion around in the laboratories. This data can be combined and looked at for the potential of possibly building digital biomarkers for individuals.
With colleagues at Imperial College, we use a cognitive test battery to assess cognition with a variety of tests in a home environment and in the lab.
Since we are collecting a number of variables, we can study the relationship between activity, bed occupancy, and light.
Here on our study, the participants wear light devices, like this ActiWatch that they wear in the wrist, or these hub devices, like they usually had one at home and they wear the other one 24 hours a day.
So here we are in DRI room 002, where we can record sleep for the future. Here you see we have our radar systems in place. I can simply put up a headband rather than all of these different sensors, or maybe even easier, simply plug in an in-ear EEG device. The next thing I do is first of all take off my shoes, then I take off my jacket, and then I'm ready to go to sleep. Good night.